So in the previous video, we talked a lot about average variable cost, average fixed cost, average total cost, and the marginal revenue. So let's talk about some more scenarios here. Now, suppose I'm operating in a perfectly competitive market where it is easy for new entrants to enter the market. And information in the market is freely available and the market determines the price. Okay, so in this case, my marginal revenue is nothing but the price. Now let's start with a scenario where the industry is relatively new and initially there are few players in the market. Now let me draw a graph to understand this. So on my x-axis, I have the quantity demanded. On my y-axis, I have price. And then this is my marginal cost curve. So you all know what is marginal cost. This is my average total cost curve. And this is my average variable cost curve. Okay. Now suppose the price of my product is P1. So I put P1 here. Now here, remember the price P1 is nothing but my marginal revenue. That is the additional revenue that I generate when I sell each additional unit of my product. So this means that I should continue to produce as long as I'm generating a marginal revenue, which is higher than my marginal costs. So the most optimal point of production would be where my marginal revenue is equal to the marginal cost. Because if I produce more than that, then my marginal cost, that is the cost for each additional unit that I'm producing, each extra unit that I produce would be more than the revenue that I generate from that unit. So it's not a wise decision to produce a quantity where my marginal revenue is less than the marginal cost. So let's try to find a point of intersection here where my marginal revenue is equal to my marginal costs. So I put this as Q1. So this is my most optimal point of production. Now this is a highly favorable situation and very profitable because I do not have too many competitors. My price is also greater than my average total cost, which means I'm making a lot of profit. Likewise, my price is also greater than my average variable cost. Okay, so what is my profit per unit? It is nothing but the price minus the average total costs. Okay, so you can see the red line here. Now, what is my total profit? My total profit will be the difference in price and my average total cost multiplied by Q1, which is nothing but the quantity produced. So for those who are visually inclined, the total profit will be the area of this rectangle, which I have marked in red. Okay. So suppose my profit per unit, that is price minus average total cost, is $10 and my optimal quantity of production is around 100. So my total profit will be price minus the average total cost multiplied by the quantity. So in other words, it is nothing but the area of this rectangle that you can see here. So it is 10 times 100, which is $1,000. So this is my total profit. Notice that the firm is highly profitable. Now this situation will not remain for too long because it would immediately attract new entrants and the number of competitors in the industry will rise quickly. So because of this, I cannot sustain in the market if my price is at such a high level. So what would I have to do? I have to reduce my price. So I keep reducing my price till I reach a point where my price equals the average total costs. Now let's see how that happens. So on my x-axis, I have quantity. And on my y-axis, I have price. This is my marginal cost curve, my average total cost curve, and my average variable cost curve. So initially, I was operating at price P1, and my optimal point of production was at Q1. Now, I have too many competitors, so I have to reduce my price till it reaches at a point where my price is equal to the average total costs. Okay, so what is my optimal point of production here? So I need to find a point where my price is equal to the marginal costs. So I find this point here and my quantity produced shifts towards the left. Okay. Now this is a situation where I do not make any profits, but I will continue to operate my business in the short run because my marginal revenue is still able to recover some of my fixed costs. However, in the long run, I would choose to go out of this business because it's not profitable for me anymore. And secondly, it would not attract any new entrants. So in this case, my price is equal to the average total cost. And I can say that the firm is at break even. Okay. So the firm will continue to operate in the short run because my price is still greater than the average variable costs. The industry is not profitable anymore to the new entrants. Suppose the market pressure increases and I have to further reduce my price. So let's see how that happens. So here I have quantity on my x-axis, price on the y-axis, and these are my cost curves. Initially, I was operating at point P1 and I was producing a quantity of Q1. Now the market pressure increases and I have to further reduce my price, and this time my price goes below the average total costs. Now the firm is running at a loss. So optimally, I would operate at a point where my price is equal to the marginal cost curve. So let me find the point of intersection here, and my quantity produced moves towards the left. So which means I would be producing less. Now what should the firm do? Remember, the price is still higher than the average variable cost, so I would still be able to cover some of the fixed costs out of my margin. So in this case, the firm would continue to operate in the short run. However, in the long run, it might choose to sell off its fixed equipment and exit from the business. So my price is less than the average total cost. The firm is running at a loss. The firm will continue to operate in the short run because my price is still greater than my average variable costs. But the industry is not profitable anymore to the new entrants. Now, what is the amount of loss? Because the average total cost is higher than the price, so my loss will be equal to average total cost minus price times the quantity produced. So you can see the line here. So this is my rectangle now. The area of this rectangle will give you the total loss. So suppose my loss per unit is 5. And now I'm producing only 50 units. So the amount of loss will be 5 times 50, that is $250. Now let's consider a case where the price reduces to a point below the average variable cost. So let's see how that happens here. On the x-axis, I have quantity. On the y-axis, I have price. And then I have marginal cost, average total costs, and the average variable costs. Initially, I was operating at P1, which was higher than the average total cost. The industry was highly profitable and I was operating at Q1. But because of the market pressure, now my price moves to a point below the average variable costs. So let me find my optimal point of production for this price. So I need to find a point of intersection where my price is equal to the marginal cost, so my quantity produced shifts towards the left. However, here my price is less than the average variable cost, so it is not making any profits. It is also not covering any of my fixed costs, so it makes no sense to continue this business anymore. So in this case, the firm immediately shuts down, both in the short run as well as in the long run. So my price is less than average variable cost. The firm is running at a loss. It's not able to cover even the variable cost. So the firm will shut down immediately. So the shutdown point is where my price or my marginal revenue is equal to the average variable cost. It's equal to or less than the average variable costs.